Each day was as it is now. The sun exits after its long journey across the heavens. While the moon enters, the stars take their seats in the theater of the sky and the music of nature begins. And as the human race dawns, mankind has yet to find his place in that ancient symphony. There are no instruments, no drums. There's only one way, the first way, for those early human men to join in the chorus.
Well, the Taco Bell is closed. I tried walking through the drive-thru, but they...
Randy! Shh! I'm recording the voiceover for the opening video.
Ooh, can I help?
Fine. But not like that.
Oh, are we doing the bass voice thing?
Yes.
Okay, got it.
Thank you.
Where were you?
At the beginning of the Sun Monster. Yeah, I had no instruments. Ah. There is only one way, the first way, for those early women and men to join in the chorus of Mother Nature, and that was with voice. And men began singing together for the truest, most basic reasons. Girls and food. And a cappella was born. Throughout history, from that day forward, humans have joined their voices in praise, in sorrow, and in joy.
Ooh, what about those guys with the weird hats? No, not those guys. They sing in small groups. No, a quartet.
Oh, yes. The barbershop quartet continued the tradition of a cappella, making it cool.
Well, 1890s cool. Then in the 50s and 60s, doo-wop groups made it actually cool.
Cut to the 80s and 90s when Bobby McFerrin, Boyz II Men, and Billy Joel were making a cappella mainstream again. A group of young men from Indiana University were inspired and, like their ancient ancestors before them, began to sing for girls and for food. Soon these young men were singing all over campus, then all over Indiana, then
The guys didn't want SNC to end, so as they graduated and each went their own way, mostly into 9-to-5 jobs, new students were auditioned and brought into the fold.
Which is why the group still lives on today at Indiana University, having proudly graduated over 6,000 alumni.
I think it's actually around 200 or 300 students that have been in Straight Blue Chaser. In 2007, through the magic of the internet, the group's 1998 video of the 12 Days of Christmas somehow went viral. The video made its way from becoming the most popular video of 2007 to the head of Atlantic Records, who called me on New Year's Day, 2008, to ask us to come and meet with the label in New York City.
From there, SNC has released 7 albums, 4 EPs, 2 PBS specials, performed in 19 countries on 3 different continents, and colonized Mars.
Colonized Mars.
Okay, not Mars, but the rest is true. And now, without further ado,
don't forget to mention our favorite city to perform in.
Kansas City, Missouri!